Here are two young women who've come through the virus in China. Two people who've had a very different journey. And two people now with very different things on their mind going forward. Pan is back in her tiny apartment after a 2,500-mile round trip when she was forced to stay with her parents. Now, given it all started here in China, she's worried about what the world outside will think of her.
因为这件事情在网络舆论上面都已经评价的非常多，我作为中国人，我觉得我们中国是不用担心这个问题的。 I hope next year I can get a new bar.
Before that though, harassment, hassle, maybe even intimidation, that is what she's worried about. At the start of February, Shanghai was a ghost town, a city of 24 million people, empty. Not now, though. This is what a return to normal looks like.
You're feeling cold, right?
Despite the rain, Pan is happy these days. Some of her friends never came back to Shanghai. They opted instead for safer government jobs at home. But she's on her way to her new job in a bar restaurant. She is saving, though.
China rejects any accusation that it was slow to react to the outbreak of this virus. And it points to its official death toll. 4,750 as evidence that it won what it called a war against the virus. All of which means you get this. Normal life has pretty much resumed.
The economic recovery was quick. China kept people working by borrowing to build, yet again. But simply put, some think it's ended up with people making a lot of stuff, but not really buying a lot of stuff.
We do know that unemployment among migrant workers has been higher. We also know when you look at the breakdown of consumption, certain items, expensive items, luxury cars, for example, consumption there has grown very, very quickly. So that gives a sense that it's very lopsided socially as well as in terms of supply versus demand.
Lopsided or not, business for Zhou is good. Once again, people want the custom-made bags that she crafts. She told me she's a patriot. Her mum's in the Communist Party, but she's been doing some soul searching.
确实中国是首当其次是要有歉疚的，但是中国也有帮助世界各地的国家提供各种各样力所能及的帮助，这就是在弥补自己的过失。
Feeling sorry, mistakes made. It's very unusual to hear that language from someone here with party connections. Jo was on the front line back in February in a nearby village. She's even got the certificate to prove it. Saying sorry, though, is not something she thinks China's leader can do.
作为我们这些普通人，我们是觉得有歉意的。所以作为我们普通的老百姓来说，我们是身怀愧疚的。但是领导人他们可能不能说，或者有其他的原因。
And as to what those reasons might be, well, she didn't say. Robin Brandt, BBC News, Shanghai.